Okay, interesting.
Okay, great. Nice. But I don't have anything. Okay. Episode save. Okay. Switched off. Should be fine. Great. Okay, something changed about my program, so I needed some time to figure it out a little bit. But I think it's okay. Let me just put in the actual link and then we can go on. In this episode, we will make some deployment because, as I already said, I want to solve some inner stuff in here, and so I need to go through the user stories, and now I have an actual user story. And so the actual user story is this. But actually, we want to go for the deployment itself. Yeah? Okay, let's get started. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to subscribe in YouTube. Just write some questions there, and I try to answer them. And I would say, let's go. Actually, for deployment, what do you need for deployment is actually a tool which you can deploy with. You have to take care of ANT migration tools or SFDX. Those are the bullet words in this case. So I would emphasize you read through something like SFDX or also like ANT migration tool. For this, you need Java 8 installed, for example, and then you can use one of them. So I'm gonna using SFDX in this episode, but I just want to you to know a little bit more about this. So based on my environment, it's a little bit special for sure, but yeah, we have it. Yes, let's make it not dismiss, mute. I will go to the user story itself. So this field I created on my own. I just put in something there, and yeah, that could be a question how to do it. Yeah, if you have any question about this, just let me know. At this point, I just figured out the deployment. That's why I will go on. If it's going too quick, just post some questions and we are trying to answer them for sure. The most important thing, as I already said, I have a program on my own. So I go through it. Yes. And we want to deploy something. Yeah. So in the system, we already tried to deploy something, and I think there were some errors on this. You have to look for what has happened in the system so far. So you can see 25 test failures, and so yeah, we want to solve them. We could begin with solving the problems, or we just can download the stuff and try the deployment again. I would say we are going to try the deployment on the one hand. So we have one process that is running in parallel or automatically, and the other process we can do manually. And in my opinion, if you develop something or do something in Salesforce, you should do it simultaneously. So one thing should be automatic, and in the meanwhile, you can go for the manual stuff. So you never know how to solve this because a system is big and can be really big, and so you never really know. But based on your current abilities and your current knowledges about what you've seen in the system so far, you would be able to do something. So in my opinion, we should go for the outbound change set. It's called as user story 108. I think this should be the correct one. Yes, correct. So the process is going to be wide. And we are on user story 108. I will choose this one, and as you can see in my program, I already prepared which folder I want to put it in which package, and which data source is it going to be. We want to deploy something, that's why I will write it to the system. If you want to know how this works, then you just need to put a question into the comments, and then we can go for this. But by now, I will just go through it. Yeah. Maybe I will do it in one of the next episodes, but only if you post any questions. Yeah? That would be necessary. I will get the whole stuff. By now, in my opinion, we just need to retrieve this one. That's why I go and retrieve the stuff. If you want to understand what is happening in the background, that is maybe something I should show you a little bit more in detail. So I will show you what I've done in the background. The system is doing something like creating a retrieve package CMD, and within this file, I've put something like I'm going to my drive. So I just put the FF double point something, yeah. And I just change the file to the corresponding file where we have put this. So it is linked within the program itself. I don't think we go into much detail. Yeah, it is some. It's working in the background, so we are fine with that. But then we are starting the program via SFDX, and as you can see, we have a command in here, and so we want to understand the commands. Yeah, I will just put it into Ecosia, just a searching machine, and then it will write you to the corresponding comment. Not this one. Okay, we could watch a video for sure, but we are going for MDAPI. Is it my video? No. No, I don't think so. No, it's not my video. But they are also doing stuff. And in here, in the developer cons or in the developer guide, you will have all the comments. So if you want to have something, yeah, or just give you a quick overview, you can retrieve some stuff. So you can get something out of an environment or a sandbox. especially you can get change sets. In my opinion, that is the best way to go. So you could also put some packages, but the change sets are standard in Salesforce, and so in my opinion, we should use them. And with the packages, we can make backups and some stuff like this. Yeah? Restart is okay. So we downloaded the stuff. That's the meaning of this. And so maybe if you want to have an overview about this, you should go through this documentation. I really emphasize this, so you should be able to figure out what's in here and what is possible with the CLI comments on Salesforce. Yeah? It's command line commands, and so we can get something out of the SFDX. So let me see. We downloaded some stuff, so we need to unzip this. And after unzipping, we will have this folder. And in this folder, we just backup by now. Oh, no, I think it's not working. No, it's not working because we don't have the corresponding number. We can get it from here, so I will put in the corresponding number. It's really specific to my company, I would say, but maybe there are some questions you have, and then we can go for it. Now we need to go for the unzip again. I think it's fine, and then we need to go for the backup actually, and then the backup is going to be put in here. But I will verify it for sure. You will see some. It's only with my program, but you will see something like this. And then, okay, we have a backup. It's the same time, so it's gonna be fine. And also we go into the deployment stuff. And I want to run all the tests, but I want to deploy it into the production. So it's gonna going from DevTiny 2 to the production environment. So what we're gonna do is, we will just backup already have, so we're gonna deploy, and now it will try the magic. Yeah, it will try to deploy something. You will see the deployment in here and in the status itself. So we refresh it again. As you can see, the deployment components are gonna be fine so far. So we don't need to do anything about here. But the tests we will leave alone by now. We will come to this later on. But we need to remember this. Yeah? So we will just go for the last failure. So the failure was about my, I think. Created blah blah blah. Yes, Buchungsordner blah blah blah. And plan blah blah blah. Let me go through it a little bit. Example. Okay, the 12. Okay, this is what happened in here. And so we just deployed it, but nobody put it on. So now we have the actual errors, and maybe we should go and solve them instead of solving the test failures on here. So we will skip the other test failures because we need the actual ones. And so we go for insert fail, first blah blah blah, required field missing, okay. It's in the test class, there's gonna be a required field that is missing, okay. I don't know why it is, but let's figure out why. I don't want to make a big overview about this. Maybe the other stuff is already taken by this. Or let me just take the six errors, a certain fail. Maybe it's because of the unique something. Yeah, let's go for the unique required field is missing. Also the unique name for something, but it's insert new project, right? What's gonna hear? Create working times, okay. So the unique names are not working properly. Okay. There are some unique names that are not working properly. And let's see why it is. So maybe in the production there can be a lot for sure. But let's go for this. Yes. Okay, let's just dive in and let's try to solve this. We will solve it in here. So we are going for the test itself. Interesting. ABZ automatic drive alert test. It's not existing. Okay, that's really interesting. Okay, no, that's the class name, that's fine. Actually, okay, this is gonna be existing, so this is not existing. ABZ automatic blah 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 test. It's interesting. And we should get it into the environment then. Yeah? So it's not in existing, that's why we need to put it into a new change set, I would say. Yeah? Let's create or get a new a change set out of Salesforce itself. And we will have the user story 8, okay. That is all that is existing in the system in here. But let's say we are not getting this because it's already used. Let's create a new change set. Let's go for March and let's go for US 108. Yeah, we are just putting it in and then we're gonna have it. And we are putting in the white corresponding Apex class. By now we have some developers in the environments, yes. Maybe we could spread this because we don't have the test in here. What is that? ABZ automatic drive automatic ABZ. Okay, that's interesting that this is gonna be in here but nowhere else. It's about the process. Yeah, we made a mistake in the process, or we should extend the process a little bit. In my opinion, it came from from another development, and so we should share it with other environments too. But it's not sure what is quicker. Yeah, let's just get this stuff. And we will just get Apex class ABZ automatic something. ABZ automatic LUT test. Okay. Let's put it in. That's gonna be the right one, I would say. Let's toggle, yeah. Because we need to get something out of the production line. We will let the project order folder, I would say. And we are going for the corresponding change set. So something is not existing in the environment. That's why we need to put it into outbound change set. And then we are going into our program and put in the corresponding change set name. You need this name for sure. And then we can go for like retrieve the package. And then we are getting the package for sure. Yeah. Retrieving means you will get the package itself. Itself in here. Then we are going to deployment, put in the stuff there as well, and also into the backup tool. Yeah, because it's the backup. And so we are gonna have green. So we download the stuff. We need to unzip, yeah, but in my opinion, we don't need a backup because the one is not here. Yeah, I think it's not here. No, the class itself is not here, and we should go just for one class because we don't know the system maybe properly, and so we are going for this. And then we are just no, let's go with or without test. We should just put it in to the system, in my opinion, because it's just a development environment, and the class is not existing yet, so we can go for it. Let's deploy this. Yeah. So it's gonna be fine, in my opinion. After deployment, we should refresh the developer console. Let's just close all tabs. Let's get the open. And let's try to get this one again. And as you can see, we have to go step by step. Why is that? Okay, now, as you can see, there's going to be an error. or something went wrong, but we can go into the deployment status. With the deployment status, we have an overview what happened actually today. Yeah, it's going to be two errors, so we need to solve the errors first. Invalid type, yeah, the mock and the let we also need. Yeah, so we need to put in the mock and the let. Yeah? Always put as little components as possible to make it not too complicated. Yeah, that's really important. And so we go for the abz let mock. Yeah, we will just put it in abz let the mock, and also the abz automatic drive LUT. Yeah, that is what we're gonna put in here. Yeah, then we're gonna edit, and it is gonna be in the outbound chain set itself. Okay, now we download again. Yeah, because we changed something in the outbound chain set, we need to retrieve again. We are getting this window then, and then we will need to put the corresponding number again, but for deployment we just need to put this number. Yeah, if we downloaded the stuff, if it's just green, we can go for deployment, because we don't need to make a backup, as there's those items are not existing. That's why we need to deploy, and it's fine. Yeah. Go for the deployment again. What is going to be happening in here? As you can see, we're going to have 7 errors by now. Yeah. That's fine. Variable does not exist. The ABC or just a folder. Yeah, the Arbeitszeiten folder or working times or something. Yeah. So as you can see, we need to push back all the stuff. Yeah. And so maybe we should go for the corresponding change set or something. No, just let's add something again, the Arbeitszeiten ordner. I think it's a field. Let's go for this one itself. We will go into the developer console of the production line. We will open up the class itself, yeah, because the error is going to be in the class itself, and we are looking for the ABC ordner. Yeah. Yes. Let's go into the ABC folder. We will. Okay. That's connection, Google connection. Okay, we need to get the field of the Google connection. As you can see, the bigger the change it is getting, so the likelier it is to get failures. Yeah? So we go to this one. We go to, let's say, Arbeitszeiten ordner. Yeah, it's going to be A R Arbeitszeiten. Ordner, no, I think it's going to be Arbeitszeiten ordner ID, is it? Let me see. We can just figure out if we're just going into the system itself, and then we can get the corresponding underscore C. As you can see, it's the same AP name, so we can get it. Add to change set, then we are going to be fine, and then we take care of the next one. Invalid type, as you can see, it's the line 95 in the corresponding class. So the line 95 needs to be here. The working times itself, and so we need to put in all the metadata working time. Yeah? So what we're going to do, we're going to have the working time itself, as it is a metadata type. We need to put in the metadata itself, working time. Yeah, itself, so all the working times, because they are not existing in the other system yet, so we need to put in all the working types that are existing already in this system. Yeah, we are just pushing it over to the other system. We're gonna add another one. We're gonna get all the corresponding custom metadata types, and we're gonna get the metadata type working something. That's why we go to W and we go to working time. Yeah, and also we need to put in all the corresponding fields for the metadata type. That's why on the one hand I go to the object manager, to the metadata types. Always if there is loading something, I will use this time and click on here. And then we go to custom fields, for example. Custom field. Yes, custom field, and then I don't know. We just go for the type, for example. Then we have to look for the working time. I think we should just order it in this way. Okay. It's not working, as you can see. It's not really good. So we go to the working time itself. And we will go for the corresponding field name. Okay, just the field name. Okay, then we go for F, I think. We will just order by name again. Go for the, is it field name? Yeah, let's go for the field name itself. Field name. You can verify it via here. You can have the working time. And as you can see, we just need an order of this one. Yeah? So settles should work for it. But they also you could put in an idea or to push this. Okay, let's go. It's in the outbound change set now. So we're gonna go back to deployment. As you can see, the work item. Let's go into line 101. The work item itself is not existing because the type was not existing, so I think this should be done. Dependent class is not there, so it's the same error, I would say, and also this one. So in my opinion, it should be gone by now, so we're gonna have 7 errors. Let's go for the actual error. So I think we just figured out everything. No, it's gonna be fine in my opinion. So the 7 errors should be gone, and maybe there come new errors, it can be for sure, but we will follow the process again. Let's go for retrieve. Let's retrieve the stuff. We will retrieve everything. And we will go like put in this one. So we only have new data or new metadata, and that's why we only need to put in or to deploy something. Because we have new stuff. If we would have existing stuff already, we should take a backup, but we don't have new stuff, or we don't have existing stuff, and that's why I will go for the deployment already. That's gonna be green, that's fine. And so it pulled everything. We can go for deployment. Yes. The deployment is going again. So as you can see, it will go right away. In the meanwhile, I would say we go for this one because we already have failures, and we need to make sure that the failures are going to be gone. Yeah. So we have 24 errors, less than last time. As you can see, the unique name is going to be not okay. And the assertion is not going to be okay. Okay, assertion fail. Required field is missing. Also on the unique name. Also, it's the Arbeitszeitaufteilung test. But let's say we are going into this one. Yeah, we're just going for this one. Let's open this and let's open the corresponding file itself. And in the meanwhile, we can have a look on the deployment. It's already deployed. So we can go for the first error or for the second error. We just choosing. Yeah, just let's go for the first error because it's always good to go in order. So we're going for the first error. Let's go for something like open up. Yeah, open up the corresponding test. We need to refresh the page because it's new stuff in the background, and so we need to close it again and open up the classes. Yeah, and then we're gonna have the test. We are trying the one test, But as you can see, the developer environment is not corresponding with the production environment. And so maybe we should decide to. Oh, as object was retrieved, okay. Requested field, okay. Without querying the requested field, interesting. And so maybe we should decide to equalize the production and also the developer sandboxes so we can produce better results. Maybe we should go this way. But let's see. It depends on what we have to do. But I would say let's go on. And as object was retrieved, it's a little bit different, as you can see. It's a different error. Yeah, now we have to figure out why is this the case, yeah? We are just going for as object row. As object row was retrieved. So I will put it in and follow the process. Fatal error, okay, it's gonna be a fatal error without yeah. So in here you know it's gonna be in here in the test itself. Yes, so we opened the test already and then we are in line 15. And as you can see, it's gonna be in create working times itself. So the special line is this class itself and also the corresponding line is 32. So as you can see, con, yeah, that's a Google get Google con connection. Ah, okay, the Google Launch Page Controller. And now it's going to be interesting because the Google Launch Page Controller is existing in this system, and we should always make sure that the corresponding system or the production is as close to this system as possible. Yeah? We have no system in between by now. Yes, it's gonna be fine. So what we're gonna do? Get Google connection loaded. Yeah, that's gonna be the corresponding. And in my opinion, we are not getting everything in here, so we should compare this with the same data in the production line. So we go in here. This is the old data, so you're gonna put compare set as first compare. You know that's the old to compare. And also we need to go into the production line. Yeah, you we'll verify this, and you will also go get the Google Launch Page Controller. Yeah, we will go in. We will just developer console. We just open up the Google itself, Google Launch Page Controller, and we get everything in here. We will put it, and we will compare this one. Yeah? We are just comparing this, but as you can see. Can we see something? On the right-hand side, you will have an overview about this. And here, it can be that something is different, but as you can see, nothing is different there. Okay, that's a little bit strange. I would have expected something would be different, but it is not. Let's figure out the corresponding stuff. Okay, let's go in here again. We are getting the get Google connection. In my opinion, we are getting all the stuff in here. Yeah, we are getting the Google connection there. And so the con, the Arbeitszeiten Ordner is not yeah, gonna get out of the database. Yeah? So we're gonna get here. And as you can see, we don't have the corresponding line. Okay. It never, okay. It's not happening in the other system, but I think it's not a big deal. So we change something in the Google Launchpad controller. As you can see, it has been created a long time ago and it worked a long, long. Okay, itself, it's working, so, but why is that? Actually, I already, I don't. Okay, that's a little bit strange that it ever worked. Okay, but let's see. We will just add one, add date, 2021, 3/4 March, add author, Christoph Lieske, and add US 108, I think, right? The user story is going to be 108, correct. So we changed something in here. Now we need to go to the outbound change set itself. Put in the just try it. I think we have we have too many items in here, so we need to go like this because, in my opinion, it's quicker. We go to the Google Launchpad Controller, Google something, Google Launchpad Controller. Yes, we add in the change set. Now we have it. That's fine. But we still need to solve the issue, so we need to get the corresponding Arbeitszeiten ordner. And so we need to go for the method again. And also we have to add one in here, right? So we go for it. Get Google connection loaded. That's going to be fine. And we have some fields in here. And we need to add the corresponding field as we are using it in here. Arbeitszeiten ordner, and also add something to we have the line 22 the line 227, and we will go for like for the corresponding container. Then we will put it in like the container. Also, we need to emphasize the apex apex class dot add blah 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 add one, and we just save this. So it's a little bit strange that the process came through within Salesforce itself, because the classes are the same, and based on this you can see that even Salesforce is not perfect, so you should always be careful, and as a society we need to make it as equalized as possible, so it needs to be balanced, and it is not, as you can see. So that's what I can see. The folder itself is going to be here, so we're gonna go for the test again. Actually, we should come into the same issue. List has no roles for assignment. Okay. Let's go for no. List has no roles. Okay. Let's go for the for this one. The mock itself. Yes. Open please. Then we go for the mock. Let's clear this. No. Let's go for the mock. This is no rows, correct. Get source body line 17. Okay. Let's go for the 17. Body to string. Ah, this one, static resource. Okay, that's going to be a static resource, and we're going to need the static resource name. Ah, okay, relating to, okay, yeah. As you can see, the mock itself will be called somewhere. Yeah, so we are not finished yet. Yeah, so we don't have everything in this environment yet. So I hit string, shift, H, and I will put in everything. I will find the mock where it is going to be used. So the mock is going to be here for sure. It's going to be here, okay, for sure. And it's going to be here when I set the mock itself, okay. And then it's going to be here as the metadata string, okay. Okay, get source body with this one. So this is going to be one static resource. This static resource we need to put in here in our production line. Just go into the production line, get the static resource itself. Yes, the static resource. And the static resource is SR enough children. And as you can see, there's also another one that is going to be in here, SR20, blah, blah, blah. That's why I will get this one as well. Metadata string or Yamamanka metadata? Let me see. Metadata string, okay. Metadata string, this one. Let's add this. It's going to be fine. Yeah. So we're going to have it in there. But we need to put it in here because list has no walls for assignment. Means it is not written in this area. Means we need to put it in. Means we are getting it from production line and we are pushing it. Yeah. So what we're going to do is we retrieve the package again. Now we have an overview if the corresponding classes are there or not. So we need to make a backup. That's why we need to put it in here. Wait for it to happen. So it's going to be green. It's fine. So we need to unzip. Yeah, we make it blind. Yeah, we just make it blind because the process is already proved. Let's go for the backup. That's going to be fine as well. And after backup, we can deploy the stuff. Yeah? Now we are waiting for the program to happen. Yeah, just in case we have a backup, we wait for it to be green. It's green. Then we can go again. Deploy the stuff, wait for it, and be happy. Yeah, let's save it again. We are always saving the last thing, and we are going to in here and try to figure out something. I think we changed something already, but it was not. I hope it was not this one. Did we change? No, I think we didn't change anything yet. It's fine. We just changed this one, but it's not in this outbound change set, right? Yeah. Okay, it's not in this outbound change set, so it's going to be fine, and we can deploy it right away. Yeah. If we would have changed something in this environment, it's going to be in this outbound change set too. We would have a not a good one. Yeah. So based on this, so we are not finished with this yet. That's why we are running the test again. And then it should working. Yeah. Yeah. List has no roles for assignment to as object. Okay. Good to know. Let's go for this one. List has no roles. Get source body. That's the mock 27. Okay. The respond mock 28. It's going to be in here. So this is going to be, yeah, a static resource we also need. Yeah. We don't really need an overview, just an overview about in the mind, and then we can go like this. But let's say we are getting this one. We are just putting an outbound something. Then we are going for static resource. Then we are going like this one. Add to the outbound change set. In my opinion, we are not putting any new stuff, yeah, in the environment. So, or some ex we are not putting any existing stuff. So we can just download and upload. Yeah? That's gonna be fine. Yeah, we can download everything. So we're gonna go into retrieve again. Let's hit retrieve button. Let's go for the corresponding number. Then we are going into the deployment itself. We're going to hit back the deployment. The result is green is fine. As this is going to be... Yeah, guys, that's not good. Mute, thank you. And then... yeah, we just... downloaded already, and then we're gonna go deploy. Yeah, deploy again, and then we are just waiting for the system. It should be running, I think. Let's refresh this, and if it's refreshed, we can go on with the test again. As you can see, it's success. Okay, then we go on with the test again in the developer console. And we do it until everything is fine. Yeah. As you can see, there's something in the system is changing, but now we got a success, and now it's not really visible why we are getting an error in the deploy.
Okay.
Guys, please let's thank you. No, sorry. Okay, great. I would say I will save this for the next episode. But I will save it for the next episode, I would say. Thanks for listening. Have a nice day. Bye bye.